what I'm to understand, as it's been told to me, the events that took place with my stepfather and my mother, as soon as the outdoor ban was lifted from the Boston and the metropolitan surrounding area, they went outside for a breath of fresh air for the first time all day, being one of the nicer days in early spring Boston. They were out in the backyard perusing, and David had walked the perimeter of the yard, and the wind had picked up during the day, and the tarp on his winterized boat had sort of been flapping in the wind, which was very strange despite all the blizzards we've had all year, and everything was intact. And upon further inspection, he got closer and realized that one of the retention straps had literally been cut, not chafed, not broken or unhooked. There was a small amount of blood, or what appeared to be blood, on the tarp. He grabbed his step ladder to kind of look inside, and maybe an animal or squirrel or something had nested inside, not really sure. He basically stuck his head under the tarp, noticed a pool of blood. It was a blue tarp. It was somewhat partly cloudy at the time, so he really couldn't get a clear view of the forward of the boat, but he definitely noticed there was something crumpled up in a ball in the forward portion. And at that point, he became an absolute hero instead of being a hero at the moment and yelling at the what we now know was the suspect. He did the right thing, as you know, law enforcement had urged. He jumped off the ladder. He called 911. They were within foot traffic distance. Immediately, my mother and David were evacuated from the home. They left their cell phones behind, which put my sister and our immediate family into panic because we couldn't reach them for almost 40 minutes. No one knew where or what was going on. We could see their house on satellite television, and you know, they had the house zeroed in on. And in the end, law enforcement, what we're putting together is law enforcement immediately swooped in, evacuated them, brought them to a safe haven, to an unknown neighbor's house. And from there, the law enforcement swept in, got this kid in another gunfight. And
when all this was happening, were you in the knowledge that your parents were safe? Or did you think they were still back in the house?
Absolutely. As the bullets were coming across the television, my sister and I were in close communication with each other. We only saw the bullets. We only heard that there was a man covered in blood in the boat. We couldn't reach the household. They had already been evacuated, unbeknownst to us. Their phone line at the residence, for whatever reason, whether it was cut, whether it was just dropped, it was giving us a busy signal. It was absolutely horrifying. For approximately 40 minutes, we had no idea what was
terrifying.
Going on. Yet the reports on the television were a bloody body in the boat. I'm thinking, oh, my stepfather, this is awful. We couldn't get in touch with anyone. It was definitely horrifying.
And when was the moment you were able to speak to them again and realize they were safe?
After a joint effort between my wife, myself, with a cell phone, a residential phone, so we had three phones contacting every possible number that we could, to no avail, that I literally just threw the phone down and just ran out the back door, jumped into my vehicle, left my home here in Natick, and went over to my father's home in Natick to see if I could communicate better through my business and the several phones I had there. My sister contacted me within 5 minutes of me arriving there, and she said, "Mom's called. They're safe. They were evacuated. Apparently, one of the police officers or someone must have handed a telephone to them and said, you can, you know, tell people you're safe." And then at that point, my tears of horror went to tears of joy.